good, girl.
Thank you. So I got the honor of introducing the special guest today, and I think I've done this about a dozen times already, so I should probably just record it and play it back, but she always does something more outrageous between the times that I get to introduce her. Most recently, of course, in protesting the unbelievable idea of having a beauty contest in a Muslim nation, Pamela donned her bikini again and tweeted that out for everybody because we don't like beauty contests without bikinis. And that's just one of the things she's done lately. But I have to take a moment to say that if you believe that one person can change the world, then I hope that Beverly doesn't really give up on Lieutenant Michael Behenna, because the reason that case even got as far as it did and that writ of cert was even given to the Supreme Court was because a listener on my show who had taken his case to the Supreme Court and succeeded and actually won his case in front of the Supreme Court, and I was there that day when it was argued, it was the very first day of this session, he heard me talking about Michael Behenna. He's a former Marine, and he became obsessed and got Jeff Fisher, who is the number one constitutional lawyer in the country, and then 36 generals to sign on to that writ. Even if it didn't get accepted, it was a monumental accomplishment done by one listener to one local radio program. And he hasn't given up yet. He's got a couple of large Democratic donors in his pocket, and we believe that we are going to get a commutation of the sentence for Michael Behenna before he serves out his sentence. And that's the day that Michael will cut this wristband off of my wrist, which has been here since the day he first, the website went up, Defend Michael. So I wanted to challenge that. One person can do a lot, and if you don't believe that, you should meet our speaker. Because the very first time I met her, we were standing in front of a federal courthouse, and we had no idea what to expect. It was Danita and Jack. It was like maybe 10 of us. And at the time, Lieutenant Colonel Alan West, who was running for Congress, and there were these two crazy people running around with video cameras. One was Tom Trento, and the other was Pamela Geller. And they were infiltrating the side of the street. There were 10 of us by the Baptist church, and there were hundreds of Muslims being led by an imam. And I mean, it was absolutely the most frightening thing I'd ever been in, really. And I've been to some pretty serious protests and rallies in my life, but this one was the scariest thing. And they began to come over to our side of the street, and the police at this time had no idea that this was going to go down. Yeah, I think there were three or four policemen present. And then the next week, there were like hundreds in helicopters. But that week, nobody was there. And I'm watching this woman just skirting around the outskirts of the crowd with this video camera. And I'm thinking, I know her. Where have I seen her before? Well, it was because I read her blog. But who knew? I thought she wore a superwoman outfit all the time because that was what was on the cover of her blog. And so they said, no, that's Pamela Geller. And I said, wow, that's pretty intense. I've read her. She's, you know, she's something else. And then I watched them. That piece of video that they obtained that day changed the perception of Jews in America about what their role was going to be going forward in this fight against the theocratic Islamic group in this country that called themselves at that time the Palestinian Street. And it was when people saw them yelling, Hitler should have finished you back in the ovens and all the rest of it, on Andrew Breitbart's idea of going straight to the people, that changed the movement. The next week we had 5,000 people standing on our side and only 100 on their side. So there is power on the internet. There's power in these bloggers. You know, I had this conversation. It's funny because this week I saw there was a posting comparing you to another one of my good friends. And when I go down the list of my good friends in this movement, it's mostly women. And most of us have extremely risky lifestyles now because of what we do, whether it's Ann Coulter, or it's Michelle Malkin, or it's Pamela Geller, or it's even the various radio hosts around the country who take a stand like I do, it's a pretty scary position to find yourself in. Pam and I met in New York a couple of months, well, I guess it was a year ago, and I came out of the, where was I, ABC or CBS, one of the big broadcast networks where I'd been using the studio, and I came out, and Pam's like walking down the street, and I said, girl, are you armed? And she said, no, you can't, I'm not armed, what are you talking about? And I said, you walk the streets of New York like that? Yeah, I won't even walk in Fort Lauderdale without a gun. So I can't imagine. She didn't have a bulletproof vest on or anything, and now the two of us are going to Starbucks. And all I'm doing is sitting there thinking, this is the most dangerous thing I've done since that day with the Muslims. There's something about Pamela Geller that always puts me in a perilous situation. But that's okay, because the bikini-clad warrior, the gal in the Superman suit, has grown to be very important to me. She is my inspiration, you know. We need inspiration, the women warriors out there. We look to one another, and we continue the fight. Breitbart had an interesting comment once about women in this movement. And he said, isn't it interesting that when you get these big panoramic views of tea parties or the what was it, the 828, all of these things, there's three women for every guy. And I'm not putting you guys down, I'm really not, but there's three women for every guy. And Breitbart said, because they're somebody's mother. And that's why I'm here, and that's why I do what I do. Because I'm somebody's mother, and now I'm somebody's grandmother, and my grandson is not going to have much of a world in which to live, and he's certainly not going to have a country like I had to grow up in, and that grieves my spirit tremendously. So we do what we do on a daily basis because Pamela has children, and I have children, and Danita has a child, and believe me, the Vaughns gave up their child for this country. I refuse to lay down and take down and not stand for what those men put their lives on the line for bravely every single day. The least we could do is fight back.